There's someone watching the Kardashians selling jewelry in a tiny Facebook video. There's someone watching a YouTube knitting tutorial on a 4K television. And the next minute, those can be reversed. So if we want to reach our audience, the same video needs to be crystal clear no matter how big or small the screen. That means we have to do two things simultaneously that seem like they're designed to cancel each other out. Make a 55-inch 4K TV quality video, but tiny enough to play instantly on a phone. Fortunately, we have the tools for that, as long as we use them properly. So let's find out how to make our videos play perfectly anywhere, on anything, in this crazy new media melting pot world. Hi, I'm Steve Washer, and this is the 5-Minute Authority, where people learn how to project their natural authority using video, or just make them look cooler. And today, that means way more than the desktop computer. People are watching you on TV. Now, for us, it's still under 3%, but not long ago, it was like a 1/10 of 1%. How are people watching your stuff? The answer is probably on whatever screen is closest. According to YouTube, a fair number watch on TVs, tablets, and phones. And I expect the mobile number to absolutely blow up this year. Why? Because 5G is coming. 5G is the new wireless network standard, up to 10 times faster than 4G. That sounds kind of like unlimited data. So no one is going to have to wait until they get home to watch your latest video. In fact, you might even want to add a disclaimer on the front. Please engage your car's autopilot before watching this cat prepare sushi. And so much for phone video. That's just the low end. Then we've got TV and the internet merging. You can't really even buy a TV that doesn't hook up to your Amazon Prime or Netflix account anymore. And then there's the 4K issue. I just did a search on Walmart, and they're showing like 720 of them, many for the price of a month's worth of grande caramel lattes. Can 8K be far behind? So the challenge now is, how are you supposed to get your video ready for a phone screen that merges with a TV screen that merges with a laptop or desk screen? Like I said, a total media melting pot. Okay, so I'm going to slowly walk you through this, and at the end, your videos will look and sound marvelous wherever they're shown. The exciting news is that we finally have the new encoding formula I've been waiting years for to be ready for prime time. A formula that cuts file sizes down by almost 100%, and that's part of what I'm going to show you now. And while I am going to give you a recipe, it's important to understand the principles behind this. Yeah, in fact, they're more like laws. Violate them at your own risk. And remember, the look of the interface, where the menu items show up, even what they're called, all that can change overnight. That's another reason I want you to understand the principles. That way, you're less likely to get confused by the updates. First law, always digitize your video at the highest possible resolution that your video host will accept. We'll do two here, one for the web and one for devices like Game Boys, Rokus, and iPods. Second law, never upload to YouTube straight from your phone unless you can confirm that it's going up at least 1080p. 720 will no longer cut it. And don't forget the computer law, GIGO, garbage in, garbage out. If your video was shot blurry, you can't unblur it. Now we're going to use Handbrake again, which works on a desktop or laptop, not mobile. So first we've got to get this onto our computer. Now be careful where you download Handbrake. Only download it from Handbrake's official website at handbrake.fr. Anywhere else, and you might also be getting a heaping helping of malware. The link is below. Once that's on the desktop, we open it and go to work. So now we've got a video loaded here, and this is a 4K video. The first thing that we're going to do is note that we have this advanced tab open here. It's available. We're not going to use it though, and I'll explain why in a moment. But I just wanted you to see that if you still want to use it, you can go up here to Preferences and note under Advanced that it says Show Advanced Options Panel, deprecated. What does that mean? Well, we'll talk about that in a minute, but basically it means it's not supported anymore. And so we're not really going to talk about this, but I just wanted you to see it because it actually works and it's pretty cool. But I'm going to show you a better way, a simpler way. So now the video is loaded and ready to go. And before we do anything, we're gonna choose a place on the hard drive to save it. Now I should say here that this is the Mac version of the software, and the Windows version of this software works exactly the same way. The only difference is that with the Windows version, you can actually drag a video right onto the software. And here we open it up by clicking open source. You can do that with Windows as well. Anyway, we select the place for it to go by clicking on browse, and we're just gonna go ahead and put it on the desktop where this one is. So we choose that there, and we'll start over on this side and work our way over. And the first one that's relevant is audio. We're gonna keep that at AAC. Stereo, 48 sample rate, and 320 on the bit rate. That looks good. We're going to keep that. Then we'll go over to video, and we're going to choose a frame rate that is same as source. And we're going to choose variable frame rate because, it just works better if we choose constant frame rate. Then that's going to give us the lowest common denominator. So we'll choose variable frame rate. And now the really big change here is that we're not going to use H.264 anymore. We're going to use H.265. H.265 is the new codec that is twice as efficient as the older H.264 codec, but until now has not been completely compatible with the video universe. Now I'm happy to say that this is the new state of the art in video encoding for the web, so go for it. Bye-bye, H.264, except for coding for devices. So if you are digitizing for the Rokus and the iPods and devices of the world, you can just choose H.264, but everything else in this entire recipe will be the same. So I'm just gonna go ahead and put it back now so we can finish this out. To H.265. And now we're going to go down here and make sure that our encoder option preset is set to medium. This just lets the encoder be a little bit more efficient at the cost of a little bit of speed in the encoding. Then we're going to choose constant quality here, and we're going to raise this to lower to 22. And now we're done here, we'll go over to dimensions, and we're going to select our 3840 by 2160, which is our 4K. Then go to summary. And on the summary page, we're going to make sure that web optimized and aligned AV start are selected, and that our wrapper, or the format, is MP4. This is really important because this is what YouTube and Vimeo and, well, really practically any other video hosting site is looking for. And that's all we need to do to get this ready, except for one thing. Before we hit start, we're going to save this preset so next time we don't have to go through this whole operation. And to do that, we go up to presets, click the plus button, give it a name. I'm going to call this 4K setting under My Presets. Click Add. And now that is captured for us forever. Now click on Start. Looks like I had one in the queue already. So we'll just wait for this to finish up, and then we'll compare them. And it's finished, so let's take a look at the two videos. Here is the original. That is 1,240 megabytes, or 1.24 gigabytes. And the created video here is 28.4 megabytes. That's about 97-98% smaller. But how do they look side by each? Let's take a look. Here's the original on top, the clone underneath. When seconds seem like hours, why not fill the time with something that can actually help you? Really hard to tell the difference, either in video or audio. Now there is this other procedure for using the advanced options, but the Handbrake folks keep saying that this whole advanced interface is going away in the next version, though they've been saying that since 2016, we'll see. But I've used it and taught it, and to my eye, this new procedure using H.265 is just as good, results in a smaller file, and takes about the same amount of time to encode on my machine. Anyway, that's the one I use now all the time. So now you have this awesome video, and you might be thinking, but it's 4K, is that even gonna show on a phone? Well, if you upload it to YouTube or Vimeo first, and maybe even if you don't, it's only a few megabytes, and it will look better than one that was digitized for the phone. Today, we're uploading for every crazy combination of Android, iPhone, laptop, desktop, and TV there is. Use this recipe every time, and your videos will rule. If you have a question about something I haven't covered, just ask it below, and I'll answer if I can. Oh, by the way, the video that I encoded for this tutorial is an ad template that could be used for all kinds of video ads. There's a link to it in the description if you'd like to take a look. Happy encoding. I'm Steve Washer. See you next time on the 5-Minute Authority.